Hey, have you been through tough experiences? Is life getting harder? Are you furious? Are you disillusioned, motivated, or feeling delirious? Or is life just mysterious? Whatever it is, stay tuned in.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Unified Diaries podcast by myself, Mike Versal. I hope you had a good start of the week. In these sessions, we cover aspects of life, successes, failures, relationships, problems, and other daily experiences we go through. Daily, I observe life, I witness things, and I recall experiences from the past. And through my eyes and thoughts, I create to hopefully inspire you for better days ahead. Thanks for listening in. This is episode 1. It covers loneliness and depression. Let's get started.
Mark was strolling down a foggy bridge all by himself. He stopped for a sec and took a long peep over the bridge. He contemplated for a minute. Should he jump or plead for help? He then stood ever so close, and as he began to hurdle the bridge, someone shouted,
"Stop! Don't do it! Just wait! I know, life's too simple, but there's always a principle. We can hide all the nonsense we face and become invisible. And since all that garbage is built inside you, it remains subliminal. I know, it's despicable how the world makes us think we're invincible. But remember, what matters in life is your strength and your sanity. There is no escape in the end. We have to keep that mentality. We've already lost before we started to win. And yes, that's the reality. But remember, stay calm, be positive, and prevent fatalities. Please don't do it. Don't jump."
So what is loneliness and depression? Well, loneliness, evil thoughts, thoughts of vanishing and disappearing, thoughts of no longer existing, they come in many shapes and forms. The effects of rejection, failure, discrimination, hatred, backstabbing, loss of someone you love, all these things are all cruel happenings that take place in your life and hope to destroy you and make you crumble.
And what does it do?
It makes you feel hopeless, useless, like you're not worth it. The confidence you once had inside you to achieve and overcome everything is forever gone. The little light in you that once shined is dimmed to a point of no return, which makes it impossible to want to live or to fight another day in this life, in this world that's meant to make us all struggle.
So what's the big deal?
Everyone around you somehow, someway, will notice a subtle pain that follows you everywhere you're going. You know, they start calling you negative because you don't want to always share what's really going on in your life, which drags people away from you. Because the truth is, no one wants to be around negative vibes. It's that simple. But when no one wants to be around you, that simply makes it worse.
And can it be worse?
Yeah, well, the bad thing is everyone will go through some type of heartbreak or some sort of pain that if not careful can slowly become a form of a depressive state. All types of people will go through some form. Depression and loneliness doesn't discriminate. It comes at any time.
Please take the stage.
Sure. Well, when I was growing up, one of my brother's friends was going through a lot and was heavily depressed. He lost all his valuables through lending out the things he owned to his friends. You know, before this all happened, he had a good heart. He could never say no to anyone or anything and just wanted everyone to be happy. Humble guy, cool guy who was doing well. At that time, I remember he was still living with his parents who were extremely wealthy. His parents owned a few stores. They used to have a chauffeur driving them around wherever they went. You know, latest in class Mercedes, latest sneakers, you know, so much music, so many music CDs. I remember hip hop albums, rock albums, pop albums, you name it. Life was good. The dude had all the latest stuff, and I remember he even had the same Nike Mercurial football boots, which was the latest boots that Ronaldo wore, which is Ronaldo Lima, the Brazilian football legend. And I remember this because when he first got it and when it first came out, we were all in awe, like, that's amazing. Now, the problem was, everything he owned or had just got, he kept lending them to his friends, because they kept asking him if they could also use it just to be like him. You know, he didn't realize what was going on because the relationship they had with him was switching. You know, that were now liking him for what he had, not for who he was. So that was changing, you know. And they realized they could also have what he had because he could never say no. But he never saw this. You see, some people just want to be liked. You know, they live in a subliminal denial. Whatever it takes, they will do it. And unfortunately for him, once some of his friends realized this, they took so much advantage of him. And after a while, he stopped coming over to our house to hang out, which was really strange. You know, we didn't hear from him for a few weeks. And apparently, we heard that he had gone into some sort of sadness where he wouldn't come out of his house. You know, we couldn't understand what that meant. I mean, what's going on? You know, was he grounded? How could he be grounded? He was grown. He was a grown dude. Grown enough not to be grounded. I think he was about, was it 19 at the time? So what was the matter? I don't know. But then a little gossip started spreading. And his dad was furious that all the stuff he was buying him were nowhere to be found. Because he kept giving away to his friends. They were all gone. Now, that's a lot of money spent. A lot of money. You know? And when we caught up with him, and had a chat with him, he told us his dad had kicked him out of the house. And he now had to live with his uncle. So he was distraught and was in disbelief. You can only imagine this because it was a lot. You know, the jewelry that were gone, the PS games, the shoes, the sneakers, music disc CDs, albums, DVDs, all given away. But to be kicked out of the house? Wow. That must have been a lot of money that was spent. You know, so his life took a 360 spin upside down. The life he knew vanished before him. He didn't have chauffeurs anymore, wasn't driving fancy cars anymore, and was no longer the cool kid. He only had enough money to buy lunch in school out of his own pocket money. That's how controlled he was. And the guy was never the same again. He was depressed. His main friends left him. He was no longer the cool kid. So now he wouldn't even want to hang out anymore. He just wanted to be by himself. Just by himself. And from what we heard, he started drinking a lot. I think that's what he thought was his comfort. He was drinking out of control. And we then found out he overdosed and was rushed to hospital. He drank so much alcohol, he was rushed to hospital.
Any turning points?
Well, years later, he cleaned his act and he learned a very important lesson. Firstly, to not fully trust your surroundings, but to make better decisions and to remember that life will throw hard rocks at you, but it depends on how you pick yourself up. Will you be depressed, become a loner, or will you try and pick yourself up and learn from your mistakes? Yes, you can't control depression, but maybe try and find a way to prevent yourself from getting there. Now the dude, he now has a wife, he has children, and is living a dedicated life of a husband and a father. I guess the point is, try your best to not to get into a depressive state and don't be lonely.
Thank you. Please thank the people and summarize your points.
Thanks for listening, guys. And as tomorrow is never a promise, I wanted to leave you with my three takes surrounding depression and loneliness. First point is stay positive at all times. Someone else in the world or around you may be going through the same or even similar things you're going through today. You know, with that being said, number two, never take what you think is the easy way out, which is trying to get rid of your existence. And finally, number three, ask someone for help or speak to someone, to your closest people, people that you know well or like you, about your experiences. Don't be afraid. And finally, as a fan and pioneer of music under the radar or up and coming music, or any music you might not know already, or might know them and I just discovered them, I want to leave you with a track I listened to over the weekend, and it's called Bicycle by Philu and Clay. I'm not sure if I got the pronunciation right. But chilled out vibes, cool lyrics. You know, I listened to it, it kind of made me relax a little bit. And you know, as music is healing, I recommend you start listening to artists not everyone knows or are on the horizon. You know, you find some good gems in there. And finally, the quote I made just for you this week is, you will never lose. Choose to live. Choose to give. Thanks for listening, ladies and gents. I hope you enjoyed this episode. As always, I got your back. If you liked, grab a mic and tell everyone it's Mike Verso
at the Unified Diaries podcast.
Thanks. I don't know what I was thinking. Trying to jump. Thank you. Thanks.